In this illustration, we are going to discuss about the magnetic flux in a toroid of rectangular cross section. Here you can see the figure shows a toroid of rectangular cross section with inside radius A and outside radius B, with the tore height H. There are total N turns closely wound on it, and we are required to find the magnetic flux through a cross section of this toroid if a current I is flowing in it. Here, if I current is circulating in the toroid, we are required to find the magnetic flux through this cross section. Here, we know well that for a closely wound solenoid or a toroid, we can write for a closely wound solenoid or a toroid, magnetic induction inside can be given as, this magnetic induction inside we write as mu naught n I, where n is the number of turns per unit length. In this situation, if we consider its average radius to be r, then small n, that is turns per unit length, we can write as n by 2 pi r, because here we are given that total turns are n. Now, in this situation, we can see on the inner edge of this toroid, turns are closer, and at the outer edge, due to its large length, the turns are relatively wider or are largely spaced. So, in this situation, we can calculate the magnetic induction at a distance x, at a distance x, from axis is, this B we can write, if from this axis at a distance x, we consider a point inside the toroid cross section, it is mu naught n, number of turns per unit length, we can write n by 2 pi x multiplied by I, because for the circle of radius x, total turns are again n, so turns per unit length will be n by 2 pi x. So, here we can consider a small elemental strip in the cross section, where we can assume this magnetic induction is uniform. So, here we can write the magnetic flux through elemental strip is this d phi, which can be written as b ds, and the area of this strip will be h dx. So, we can calculate the total flux through cross section is, this can be given as integration of d phi, which is integration of, we substitute the value of b, here it is mu naught n I by 2 pi x multiplied by h dx, and here we integrate it within limits of x from inner to outer radius, that is from a to b. So, this flux will be given as mu naught n I h over 2 pi, this integration of 1 by x dx from a to b, which will result mu naught n I h divided by 2 pi, integration of 1 by x is ln x, we apply limits from a to b, and that will result to us mu naught n I h upon 2 pi, ln of b minus ln of a, that is ln of b by a. This is the answer to this problem, which is the magnetic flux through this cross section, where the windings are closely spaced on the inner side and largely spaced, slightly largely placed on the outer side. So, in this situation, the magnetic field will not be taken as uniform inside, and using the relation of flux calculation for non-uniform magnetic field, we have calculated the total flux.